the Doit Perry Field, located on the campus of Bowling Green State University, for this afternoon's MAC Sports Channel Game of the Week, featuring the 1991 MAC champions, the Bowling Green State Falcons, and of course, the visiting Flashes of Kent State University. In the starting lineup this afternoon, Kevin Schumann, the redshirt freshman quarterback, will get the call again. Brad Smith and Gregory in the backfield, and Barnes, Kaprosky, and Woody are the receiving corps. And a solid offensive line that's been improving. Had an outstanding week a week ago. As a matter of fact, both Schumann and Brad Smith rushed for over 100 yards. It's the first time that that's happened since 1970. Leroy Smith now gets it from the tailback position. Got to the line of scrimmage and went nowhere fast at that point in time. Andy Krupa, one of the defensive interior linemen, made the hit. As we take a look at that defense and how it stacks up, it's Agnew, Catch, and Krupa along the interior line. Renners, Patterson, and Norris. Boy, two excellent linebackers on the inside, and Brian Overby to the outside. And the secondary also very talented. Harris, second team All-MAC performer Paul Haynes, along with Brian Allen and Vance Benton. Second down 11, so loss of one on the first down play. And that tackle provided by Maury Norris.
Down, as you see, White watch left of your screen. He'll come around the corner here behind Leroy Smith and decides to take off for it. He's going to put his shoulder down right here. See that football? That football was just outside, and he really didn't have good control of it. And someone got him from the left as he was trying to turn up field.
And yes, the Flashes have come up with a fumble recovery, and they've got beautiful field position. The Flashes have had a chance to go on offense. Schumann rolls to the right. Makes the throw and a good one. And this time Woody hangs on and he's inside the 25-yard line. Third and five, Schumann drops straight back, throws it over the middle, and the pass is pulled in down to about the 11-yard line. That's his favorite target, Sean Barnes. Trying to take advantage of the turnover. Schumann runs the option, cuts it up and in. Nobody's going to get to him, and he's finally pulled down just outside the one-yard line. So power eye formation for the Golden Flashes. Smith, the tailback up over the top, and he has his eighth touchdown of the year, Reggie Rucker, and the Kent State Flashes, a confident bunch, takes it down and bunches it in the end zone.
Well, makes them aware that, look, we don't want to tank what we've done all year. We can't afford to lose a football game here, lose momentum.
Kick is up and it is good. So the Golden Flashes first on the board here in Doit Perry Field this afternoon. We'll take a break. 8:42 left to go. Opening quarter, 7-0. The guests on top, Kent State. White looks to throw the out pattern. Now he goes the other way, tries to go deep. Good coverage, but a great catch, and then all of a sudden, there's an interception at the 25-yard line by Kevin Harris, who simply took the football away from Ronnie Redd.
Eric White wants to come over here to Slaycheck, not there, then goes deep to Redd with good speed, but excellent coverage by Harris. Boy, he just took that thing away from him as they were coming down out of the air. Great defensive play there.
From another angle, all the way down, boy.
Well, they list him at 265 pounds. I knew that was going to be trouble out here when you saw this play coming. Watch Ted Gregory right here. Kenny Barris, 160 pounds or so. Boom, run over. But that big safety, number one, Terry Wilson.
Doing it with time. Now he flips it out to Gregory, who makes a good catch. And then an excellent move. For BG, their third offensive series. Leroy Smith running authoritatively through the hole out to about the 41.
Play upside up the field right here. They've got Lindsay right there, who one, two, three, four, five, six white shirts. And Kent State is sort of making things work their way. Schumann, I mean, he's just running, running, running. There's no one even challenging him to force him to do anything. And, of course, Duchaux right there with the catch on the sideline. The people are making the right cut. Schumann is playing very well.
Three wide receivers make it four wide receivers for Schumann, who guns it out.
Nice catch.
Pass pulled in that time by Jimmy Woody. Check it down now at seven for Eric White and company. Four wide receivers. White looks right down the middle and nearly picked off by Morris. Step into the end zone.
Yeah, he was gone for a touchdown here. Here's Norris at 5'11". About 196
shy of the end zone.
That power eye position, Leroy Smith loses his footing too. That's what happens there. He was going to leap over the pile, but his cleats
came last week against Toledo. He said Schumann makes a lot of good decisions for a young quarterback. Stood in the pocket that time and waited for the receiver to clear. It was Sean Barnes.
That football so soft. See, let this one go. Get that ball to him as quickly as you can.
Kent State was the first on the board here this afternoon, but BG has picked up the pace here in the second quarter. Reggie scoring twice, both times on the ground.
Not been beaten here.
Play action. Schumann gets it out to Gregory in the slot. He is. Turning them out, and of course the Falcons receive, well, I'm going to say a second half kickoff, but an onside kick is tried. Mad scramble for the football. Pete Cordelli pulling out the stops early on. Flashes say that it's their football, and it is, I believe. And so Kent State comes out and surprises BG with an onsider.
Head coach of Cleveland Browns. A couple weeks ago, Bill Belichick did that same play with the Cleveland Browns. It was successful. They had a penalty. Now Pete Cordelli, his buddy, comes up with a play similar to it, and they make it work. Great move. I like it.
Better bring a Parker. And Schumann steps up, players at his feet, delivers to the tight end. Boy, what a nice play that time. Danny Ford came up with a
receiver. This were the NFL, this would be called in the grass. There's someone that's just holding on to his ankle right here. Look at that.
Paul Harris was trying to pull him down by the ankle. Danny Ford hauls in the reception. Single back set. Boy Smith gets hammered by Maury Norris right at the 9-yard line.
But I wasn't interested in hitting you.
All you wanted to do was hit Painter. Leroy Smith ball tackled at about the 12-yard line by Paul Haynes,
who loves to play on a field like this.
And Smith hit in the backfield, but by the time they appear, the early stages of the third quarter, option being run. Schumann, what a nice pitch to Smith. He's got some running room down the sideline, tries to tiptoe.
He gets right into the teeth of the defense. He turns it up, and that's what threatens the defense. And we told you, Brad Smith, boy, he's quick down that sideline. 6 foot, 190 pounds. Gets it in gear in a hurry.
20-yard play on the option. First, White with the play action, a couple of fakes, waits for the receivers to clear. And now this one's picked off the other way by Kevin Harris. So two passes, two picks, and Kent State comes right back with the football.
Play action fake, Eric White. What's he going for? Is it Klejcik? Like Ronnie Redd. Yeah, it was Ronnie Redd over there, and just excellent coverage by Kevin Harris. Takes over, and the guy's with the orange shirt and orange helmet has more than Kent State.
Sean Patterson stuck his hat in there and flattened Leroy Smith at the line of scrimmage. It'll bring up a fourth down play.
Still playing hard, though, and I think that's what you look at if you can't Maurice Sumter there, number 57, John Patterson.
Well, those nose tackles don't get many sacks. New tailback for Kent State. Impressive showing after a slow start. A little flare out.